There are many other applications of dynamic programming that we haven't touched on, but the three we covered provide a good sample and help illustrate the general strategy. Perhaps the most important lesson is that anytime you've found a recursive solution to a problem, think carefully about what the subproblems are and whether there's an overlap that you can exploit. Note that this won't always work. Dynamic program will not yield a polynomial algorithm for every problem with a recursive formulation. Take satisfiability, for example. Pick a variable and set it to true, and eliminate the variable from the rest of the formula. We're left with another Boolean formula, and if it's satisfiable, then so is the original. The same is true if we set the variable to false. And the original formula will have a satisfying assignment if either of these other formulas do. This is a perfectly legitimate recursive formulation, yet there isn't enough overlap between the subproblems to create a polynomial algorithm, at least not unless p is equal to np. In the next lesson, we'll examine the fast Fourier transform. This is much more a divide-and-conquer problem than it is a dynamic programming one, though many of the same themes of identifying subproblems and reusing calculation will appear as we study it. Keep this in mind.